Is it Ann Berry, Gilbert Parkway?
Anna. Hi, I'm a young woman who is looking to run for office once I graduate school, so I go to UW-Madison. And I've lived in Brookfield my whole life, and I want to thank you for your representation thus far. But looking forward and working in politics now, I work for Representative Chris Taylor. And I've also worked with Mark Hocan, lots of other Democrats. And one thing I know progressive politics is really strong with is knowing when to step down for a new champion. Somebody who, you know, knows more, is more understanding of their constituents, doesn't bang the gavel when there's applause for something that one of your constituents says and really means and is concerned about. So when is it that time for you? You know, you've served 4 years, you know, you got your cane. When is it time for you to step down and make room for somebody new?
I'm running for re-election for two reasons. One is that I was the principal House author of the comprehensive opioid treatment bill. That's something that we all ought to be for, whether you're progressive or conservative. We need to do two things. We need to fund it, and it's not permanently funded. You need to tweak it, because there's some things that didn't hit the mark, you know, directly. And the other thing, which I've introduced a bill, which should be coming up in the House later this month, is to criminalize fentanyl analogs.
Yes.
You know, fentanyl is much more lethal than heroin is. The fentanyl analogs are more lethal than the fentanyl.
I'm very familiar with it. I work on Tammy Baldwin's campaign.
Yeah, okay, well, that's fine, but most people here are not. Now, I'm the author of the bill that will criminalize them and make them a scheduled narcotic, you know, like fentanyl. So fentanyl is used medically with a prescription to treat terminal cancer patients because it is good at dealing with pain. The second thing that I've spent quite a bit of time on for the last year and a half, and I get more support from progressives rather than conservatives, is prison reform. And prison reform requires three things, in my opinion. First of all, we ought to give vocational training to people who are in prison so they have a marketable skill when they get out. Secondly, we need a second chance program, and I was the author of the Second Chance Act, which is up for reauthorization, to make sure that we can do our best to prevent them from repeat offending and going right back into jail. The Second Chance Act basically means that they don't hang out with the people who got them into trouble to begin with. And the third thing, because of the way the mandatory minimum penalties work, there are people that might have a grain of a controlled substance more that get a mandatory penalty when they're not doing any kind of narcotics trafficking or pushing. And if they have a grain less of that when they get arrested by the police, you know, then they, you know, then they do not get a mandatory penalty. And in order to do that, you know, we need to have a probation program that works. And a lot of probation programs in many parts of the country today, you know, are calling in from your favorite drug house to your probation officer, you know, to say that you're behaving yourself, quotes unquote, so you're around behaving yourself. You know, I worked for a year and a half with Representative Bobby Scott, who is an African-American Democrat from Virginia, that came up with, I think, a comprehensive plan that was revenue neutral on it. You know, the money that we would save, you know, from not incarcerating nonviolent people who are not trafficking in drugs could pay for the vocational training in prison and the Second Chance program. So this isn't anything that would be a big drain on the taxpayers. And I want to get that through. And that's why I'm running again. And
do you
both
not
of
think
these
that
things are things that progressives ought to be kind of in favor of. And I'm the
exactly.
one Republican that's been, you know, sticking my neck out on this.
Do you not think that a progressive leader could emerge in your position and do that exact job that you just said, where you want to support all these progressive values?
I can't be Baldwin. She failed.
No.
She failed.
No. Oh, it's a check mark.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Failed at one.
Let me say, you know, that somebody, you know, a freshman is not going to be able to put together the coalitions to get that done, because this is very difficult. Somebody with experience and an institutional knowledge.
I've been asked to run, actually, like locally in Madison, so I have a lot of experience in the political world, and I work with many people who have a lot more time.
I'm talking about the United States Congress, and the United States Congress.
Mark Pocan.
You know, okay, well, he hasn't been very helpful either, so.
He actually just authored a bill to try and abolish ICE, so I mean, I think he's moving in the right direction.
Yep.
Well, if Mark Pocan wants to abolish ICE, maybe he should ask, who would be enforcing the immigration laws inside the US? With no ICE, there will be the local police doing that, and I've been involved in the immigration issue long enough.
Good.
Most immigration advocates do not allow the local police to do that. I think the local police, which is fine indeed, you're able to do that, but I think when that issue comes up to many people in this room, they will be having second thoughts about it. But if this will put out a bumper sticker.